We feel very vindicated.
David Stephan is happy the Supreme Court of Canada overturned his conviction of failing to provide the necessities of life after his 19-month-old son Ezekiel died from meningitis in 2012. Instead of taking their son to a doctor, Stephan and his wife treated their son with homemade remedies prepared with garlic, onions, and horseradish. Witnesses at the trial say the toddler's body was so stiff he couldn't sit in his car seat, so he had to lie on a mattress when his mother drove them from their rural Alberta home to a naturopathic clinic in Lethbridge, where she brought an echinacea mixture. The Stephans never called for medical assistance until Ezekiel stopped breathing. He was taken to a local hospital and died after being transported to Calgary's Children's Hospital.
We're extremely grateful. We're grateful because this is a move in the right direction.
In 2016, David Stephan and his wife Collet were convicted of failing to provide the necessities of life. He was sentenced to 4 months in prison and Collet 3 months of house arrest. The Alberta Court of Appeal upheld the conviction, but because it wasn't a unanimous decision, the couple were able to take their case straight to the Supreme Court.
Well, there appears to have been major errors within the trial judge's instructions to the original jury. And they had no choice but to find us guilty based on those errors in law.
Stephan's lawyer argued the jury was overwhelmed with medical evidence and distracted the jurors from whether Stephan and his wife acted as other parents would. They also argued the testimony from a nurse who saw Ezekiel the day before he died was mishandled.
We now have the opportunity to bring the whole truth forward, and we're just so excited to have the ability to do that and to be able to uphold parental rights here in Canada.
Last week, Stephan wrote on social media that he believes this case is being used to deprive parents of their rights in Canada. It's not clear yet when a new trial will begin. In Ottawa, Nigel Newlove, City News.